Hello, I'm Carly McAvoy. Tonight I'm doing systems of equations, and this is the substitution method. We looked at what a system is, a definition of it. We've looked at solving by graphing, and then the next step usually in the evolution of this is substitution. This is an algebraic method, so we don't have to graph. Even though graphing is nice because it's visual, it's very easy to see what's happening, it also can be time consuming, and if your answers don't come out to be integers, it can be hard to say what the actual solution is. Well, substitution method says this: if A equals B and B equals C, then that's really not what it says. Then A equals C. If A is the same as B and B is the same as C, then A must be the same as C. That's kind of what the substitution method allows us to substitute things if we know that that's true. Notice that one of our equation is solved for a variable. When it's in this format, that's when it's nice to use substitution, when one variable is sitting there by itself. So what I know is that y actually equals 3x. So if I take my first equation and I don't put the y in, instead I put what y equals. I want to put parentheses just to make sure you see that that's what I did. I took this equation, but where I used to have y, I replaced it with what y equals. I substituted. Now I can solve this. 2x minus 3x is negative x, and then dividing both sides by negative 1, I get x equals negative 6. This is not done, because remember, when you solve a system, you find an ordered pair. So we're looking for this, negative 6 and something else before we're done. All right, so I'm going to just go back and say, well, I'm going to plug in x I know now. So I know that y is 3 times negative 6, or y is negative 18. Very quickly, before I leave this, I'm going to try it up here. If I have 2 times negative 6, that would be negative 12, minus negative 18 would be plus 18. Negative 12 plus 18 is 6. That's a quick check. I just kind of saw, would it be true? So 6 negative 18, I believe, is my solution. All right, let's look at the next one. Again, it's not solved for y, but this one is solved for x. Any single variable by itself is a great time to use substitution. So I'm going to take this equation, and where I used to have x, I'm going to leave a blank. And then I have 4y equals negative 11. So I replace this x now with y plus 4. I don't have a minus in front of that, so I'm not too worried about it. But I'm going to add y and 4y together. That gives me 5y. And I'm going to subtract 4 from both sides, and that gives me negative 15. Now if I divide by 5, I get y equals negative 3. Now I just have to figure out what x is. So I'm going to go back to this equation. X equals negative 3 plus 4. X equals 1. So my ordered pair is 1, negative 3. Notice up here I solved for x first and then found y. Down here I solved for y first and then found x. It doesn't matter which one you find first and which one you find second, but you need to find them first. Well, I should have checked really quick before I moved on. I know that if x is 1 and y is negative 3, negative 3 plus 4 is 1. That's true. And x is 1 and negative 3 times 4 is negative 12, and 1 plus negative 12 is negative 11. That's true as well. So I've checked both of those. Okay, third one. This one was one I just happened to see and thought was weird with the 3/4 in there, but it doesn't matter. We're going to substitute this because we know what y is. We're going to put it into this equation. So I have 3x plus 4 times y equals 3/4. And over here, I'm saying y is 4x minus 1. So instead of y, I'm putting in 4x minus 1. I haven't solved this, but I don't know what the answer is. But I think it'll probably come out nicely. We'll see. So what I have is 3x plus 16x minus 4 equals 3/4. That's 19x. Yikes, is that right? 3/4 plus 4 I'm going to say 3 fourths plus 4 over 1 equals, well, when I have 4 over 1, I can multiply by 4, and that gives me 16 over 4, right? So I have 16 fourths. 4 over 1 is 16 over 4, plus 3 more is 19 over 4. Well, that's not too bad, because now if I multiply both sides by 1/19, then I can see that the 19s go away, and I get 1/4 over here. But that's half my answer, I think. So I'm going to put 1/4 there, and I'm going to go back. I think it's my answer. I still have to check it. But I'm going to then plug in 1/4. So it doesn't come out to be so bad. 4 times 1/4 minus 1 is 1 minus 1 is 0. So I have the answer of 1/4 and 0. X is 1/4. What about 3 times 1/4? 3 times 1/4 plus 4 times 0. Does that equal 3/4? 3 times 1/4 is 3/4. 4 times 0 goes away, and yes, that does work for that one. And we just saw that it worked over here. So that's my solution, 1/4, 0. I will tell you that on your final, any of these systems of equations, there won't be any fractions in the answer, so won't be quite that hard. And the last one, this one, it's not solved for a variable. Look, there's no x by itself, there's no y by itself, but we can easily change that. So what I'm going to do is take this one, and I'm going to move that 9y to the other side by subtracting 9y. Easy enough. Now I'm ready to substitute. So now I'm ready to say 4 times this plus 5y equals 3. This is 24 minus 9y. So 24 times 4, goodness, 6 and 96. And 4 times 9 is 36. Can't remember if I made this one up, because if I did, then I blame myself for these kind of crazy numbers. But and now I'm going to subtract 96 from both sides and get 93, negative 93. And negative 36 and positive 5 is negative 31y. Divide both sides by negative 31. And y equals 3. Well, that didn't turn out so bad. But I think that's half my answer, right? I don't know what x is yet. I'm going to go back to my original question and say x plus 9 times 3 equals 24. X plus 27 is 24. And so x is negative 3. I can do a quick check. 4 times negative 3 would be negative 12. 5 times positive 3 is 15, and that's supposed to equal 3, and it does. All right, so it checked out in both my equations, and that is the basic idea for the substitution method.